I'm Adrian, the cruise and travel guy. If you're one of the millions of people that don't live on the east coast of Australia, you know that cruising from your home or close to your home is not really an option anymore. Despite that, Western Australia held the Cruise Exchange a couple of months ago, where dozens of cruise lines were represented to talk about the future of cruise. It was only in July that the WA Cruise Exchange was held. It's a state government initiated and endorsed endeavour that brings cruise lines together with government to better understand how the state can cater to the cruise industry and to the cruisers locally. More than two dozen cruise lines were represented, with the likes of Carnival Corporations, Princess, Holland America, Seabourn and P&O Australia, along with cruise lines like Royal Caribbean, MSC and Coral Expeditions. And up to the financial year ending 2023, the cruise industry was responsible in the state of WA for $333 million worth of economic activity, and it supported 1,000 local jobs. These are fantastic numbers, and of course they're in line with other statistics that we've seen from CLIA in the past. Tourism Minister Rita Saffioti said, "It's really exciting to welcome key industry representatives to our state and discuss the amazing experiences our local tourism operators can offer their guests." Recent upgrades to Fremantle Cruise Terminal were also highlighted at the event, which is of course WA's busiest cruise port. But despite all of this, we learned just a couple of days ago that Coral Princess would be cancelling its upcoming scheduled call in the port of Geraldton. Coral Princess was expected to arrive on September 4th, which is today if you're watching the video on the day it's released, with about 2,000 passengers and of course a number of crew. All of this activity would of course help the small town's bottom line. But just 3 days before her visit, a Princess representative informed the Midwest Port Authority that Coral's stop was cancelled due to the expected impact of weather on Thursday. The Port Authority confirmed it was monitoring surge levels and that the port could safely facilitate the ship's arrival on Wednesday, despite the planned weather event for Thursday. Geraldton has seen numerous cancellations. In fact, it will have no scheduled cruise ship visits between the end of this year and 2027, with 12 reported visits cancelled between 2025 and 2026. This has been due to a variety of reasons. One of them, though, is that Geraldton can't be or doesn't have the facility to be a first point of entry for arrivals into the country. To get around that, the Australian Border Force used to send its personnel overseas to board ships and then process passengers on the way to Australia. That's no longer a service that they will be providing. While West Australian ministers are definitely advocating for the cruise industry, especially on the back of its economic benefits, this is really just proof that the entire system is broken. You can have as many conferences and exchanges as you like and discuss and celebrate all of these wins and economic windfalls and benefits, but the reality is that without a singular government body to oversee all of this, it's really just moot, and it's in fact a plain giant mess. It's a constant battle between state, federal, and even local stakeholders. All of this has contributed to Sydney's status as an unreliable cruise hub, and we're starting to see the impacts of that now and over the next few years. Despite being Australia's international tourist gateway and arguably the most spectacular harbour in the world, the city has languished when it comes to developing viable alternatives to Sydney's Circular Quay port. Heck, it's one of the main reasons that I suspect Virgin Voyages' first foray into Australia failed. That's my word, not theirs. Plus, with the end of P&O Australia and the end of Pacific Explorer's time with the fleet, that means there will be no other ship within the Carnival Australia fleet that will serve any city outside of Sydney and Brisbane for the foreseeable future. That extends well into 2026. At every turn, we're being reminded that Australia's cruise industry is beleaguered by a battle of the wheels. So potent is media discourse around the cruise industry that most politicians are, I think, too afraid to even get into it. When pressed, though, they will happily tell you about all of the economic benefits the industry brings. Just don't ask them about the future. Ultimately, I think this WA experience is indicative of where the country stands as a whole when it comes to the cruise industry, and that is at a crossroads and incredibly conflicted. On the one hand, you have industry support and political support for the industry, and on the other hand, you have a whole group of citizens and population that cannot access cruise from their own backyard and towns that are now missing out on the economic benefit of cruise because there is such an incongruous meeting of the minds when it comes to anything to do with cruise in this country, and that's a reality. In fact, today I think the Australian Cruise Association is meeting in Adelaide, and I can't wait to hear what they say about all of this. To put it mildly, most of these events occur to pat each other on the back and talk about how much the cruise industry is worth and how much it contributes to the economy, but very infrequently will you hear about this sort of thing and actual discussion about where the future needs to go or what needs to happen in the future to better support the local Australian cruise industry. And again, ultimately, that's about supporting you guys. That's about supporting cruisers that want to travel in their own backyard, support local, and go to regional towns that I still think, based on the previous videos that I've made, you can watch them, that we really need to develop into cruise ports. There is big support for all of this, but it just seems to fall down every time it gets into any position where more discussion takes place. So that's where we are. It seems to be one of those things that just is up in the air, and I think it will be for a few years to come. Hopefully some good news or some good action comes out of the Australian Cruise Association's conference this week. I'll stay tuned to that and see if there's anything, but in the meantime, you can head to my website to learn more and to even book a cruise at thecruiseandtravelguy.com.au. Give me a follow on Facebook and Instagram at The Cruise and Travel Guy, and thanks as always for watching. And if you like the video, please hit the subscribe button. Up to the financial year that ended 2023, the cruise industry was responsible for on a national scale. The Port Authority confirmed it was monitoring. Plus, with the end of Pacific...